So today I'm trying to address some of the questions and some of the concerns that you have where you've perhaps delved into Google My Business before, but you just want to get back up to speed again. I mean, if you did Google My Business listing, say a year ago, quite a few things have now changed. And so the purpose of this video is to take you through all the new things you need to know about, the very latest thinking that's going to get you extra traction over your competition, and in effect, it's a crash course so that after watching this video, you're going to be ready to do all the right things going forward with Google My Business. So I assume you know a little bit about Google My Business. You've already got your business registered. You've already got your listing there. Maybe you've added some photos. You might have even got some nice reviews coming through. But this is just going to get you a bit more up to speed. So it's worth noting that we're talking about local SEO. Now, what's the difference between local SEO and national SEO, or just search engine optimization, which is what SEO stands for? Well, simply put, local SEO is kind of the new way that Google is adapting and helping businesses succeed. Because if you're looking for, say, an estate agent for property locally, or if you're looking to order a pizza takeaway, or you need a local plumbing service, where do you go? Well, Google knows that most people want something local to them. They want people to be called out and to come within the next 20 minutes or so. They want a delivery for their pizza within the next half an hour. So local SEO is quite different to the old national SEO, where you just wanted to be number one for pizzas in the whole of the UK. And that's where you as a small business can succeed. In effect, there are some things you can do and there's some things you can't do with local SEO. For example, if someone's looking for your business, you can't get any more locally to them because your business is in a place. So there are certain things like how far you are from the person searching that you can't do anything about. But there is 55% of the algorithm that you can control. And those are the things we're going to look at today. And of that, 25% of it is based on Google My Business, which is why I particularly emphasize on my channel the importance of optimizing Google My Business. It's the biggest thing you can control to get new customers and clients locally. There are two particular things that's changed the habits of people searching for you on Google Maps or Google My Business or just on Google search engine. What are those two things? Well, one is that people are no longer using laptops and possibly even to some degree tablets. They're using their mobile phone. So most people are walking around using a mobile phone, searching for businesses, or maybe they're stuck in a car or in a car park, and they're thinking, where's the local business for this? Where's the local service for that? So the majority of people today using their mobile phones, like computers, like a laptop, to try and find businesses. So what does that mean? Well, that means you need to make sure that your website, your optimizations, and everything about your business is aimed for someone searching for it on the mobile. Now you may say, well, actually my criteria, the customers that I'm looking for don't use mobiles. Maybe they've got a certain age bracket. Maybe they're not particularly technically savvy. Well, that may be true, but it is changing so much so that the majority will be using mobiles. And you may need to change your perception if you want to attract the right customers or more customers, a greater volume of customers going forward. Now, the second thing that's changed is the search terms themselves are much more locally concise. So what do we mean by that? Well, they may use the town or the city that you're in as part of the search phrase. And that's often been misused by people on Google My Business. So there's been a misuse and this is needing to be addressed by Google. So I wouldn't suggest you go down that avenue. But what I would suggest you do is on your website, you talk about the towns, the cities, the vicinities of local things around you. That you get local links from other businesses and other associations that are around you. And also just bear in mind, certain key phrases are used by people looking for your business. If you're a flower shop, for example, many people won't type in flower shop into Google. They'll put flower shop near me or nearest flower shop. So those are words like nearest, near me. They show search intent. They show it's a local search. They show they're looking for a business close to them. So think about when you write an article, can you put the words nearest, nearby, near Bournemouth, nearest town or city that's local to you. Think in terms of the person looking for your business as opposed to what you're thinking about. And that is one of the biggest shifts in the last few years when it comes to Google My Business and Google search engine optimization. Now, if you decide to do nothing at all about that, well, that's fine. You may find that you've already got an authority in Google, but over time it will change. So there's an opportunity here. If you're a new business, or if you're a young business, or if your business just hasn't been optimized that well recently, there's an opportunity at the moment to take advantage of those types of things. So think of the perspective of how your customer is viewing your business. Have you gone to Google in, say, incognito mode, or on a browser you've never used before, so you're not signed in? And have you just tried searching for your type of business? Have you just imagined that your business, you're the customer, and you're searching for your type of business, and you put in near me? Well, obviously, if you're using a phone that's right next to where your business is, or it's within your business, you may come up number one. But what about next time you're on the other side of town, or next time you're out shopping? Just do a search in the incognito mode to see where do you truly come for the real customers out there looking for your type of business. There's an honesty required sometimes from a business owner to see it from the perspective of the customer. And when you do find your business, and maybe you've got a knowledge panel, that side panel on the side of a search engine, or maybe it comes up on the map and you click on the map and you see your business there, how much information, useful information, does it give to the customer? Does it attract the customer to pick up the phone and phone you? Are the reviews any good? Do the reviews actually tell a good representation of your business? What about the questions they're asking? Do you have frequently asked questions on there? What about the photo that's showing? What about the logos that are showing? The logo of your business, is it actually the latest logo? What about your business name, your title, your phone number? You've heard of NAP, name, address, phone number, but what about your website too? Does that have the same representation? When people search for your business, does it really strike a chord with a genuine customer? Well, most people think it always does. The facts are, when I review websites and review businesses and review Google My Maps and Google My Business, sometimes people are slightly deluded. And if you can change your thinking, if you can think in terms of your customer, then you'll be able to engage your customer with great photos, with honest representations of your business. You'll make it so attractive, it'll stand out, and people will then click on it. And that's how Google works. Because when people click on your business in Google Maps, when they're searching for your type of business, it sends a signal to Google. And Google goes, well, everyone seems to click on this. It seems to engage the customers. They get great reviews. I'm not interested in whether this business has been around for 2 years, 3 years, 10 years, 20 years. Locally, this is an authority. These guys are the experts. These guys seem to be trusted. Now, what's interesting is their expertise, authority, trustworthiness is something that I've often mentioned also in my videos. In fact, I've got several videos that talk about EAT, expert, authority, trustworthiness. And that is something that's very difficult for Google to rate. In fact, they've got guys that actually go around, they go to website addresses, and they look to see, does this look like an authority? From human perspective, they've got a book that has loads and loads of questionnaires for these Google experts to fill out and to see whether your business represents what true people are looking for in true life. So are you an expert? Are you an authority? Are you trustworthy? Well, you'll always think you are, but what does your customers think of you? And that's the type of way of thinking. That's the way Google is changing the way the algorithm is working. It's much more based on a manual process of observation. Now, at this point in the video, I just realized that there was still so much more to talk about. I didn't want to rush through all the rest of this stuff. For instance, there's a new free website you can get through Google My Business. Insights reveals a bit more about how photos are so important. How do you choose the right category? How do you keep your posts updated? And how do you make sure you fully appreciate what Google's after in the algorithm? Well, I cover the rest of that in the second part of this video, and I'll see you there. Don't miss it.